Ever find yourself scratching your head over all these tech terms like AI, machine learning, deep learning, and generative AI? I totally get it. It's a lot to take in. Today, we are going to talk about these buzzwords in a simple way. We will break down what each one really means and how they are changing our everyday lives. Hello everyone, welcome to WsCube Tech channel. My name is Ayushi Jain, and guys, today we are diving into one of the hottest topics in tech, that is artificial intelligence. But we are just not stopping there. We will also break down the differences between artificial intelligence, machine learning, deep learning, and generative AI. And I will also help you understand them with the help of a real examples. Now, first of all, let's talk about artificial intelligence. Guys, AI is an overarching field where machines are designed to mimic human intelligence. This means they can reason, learn, and solve problems in the way that only humans can. For example, you have voice assistants, like we have assistants like Siri or Alexa, right? They understand your voice, commands, and help you with the task. So that is an action of an AI. AI is basically a broad concept that includes everything from simple rule-based systems to the most advanced neural networks. Now, before we move any further, if you want to stay updated with the job updates, podcasts, masterclasses, cheat sheets, notes, and so much more which is going on in the field of data, then WsCube Tech has recently launched their WhatsApp channel where we post content about everything that is going on in the world of data. So if you want to also stay updated, the link to this WhatsApp channel is given in our description. You can join from there. Next comes machine learning. Guys, machine learning is a subset of artificial intelligence that focuses on algorithms and statistical models that enables computers to learn from data without being explicitly programmed for every task. In the example for this, you can consider a recommendation system like we have on Netflix, on Spotify. These systems analyze your viewing or listening history and suggest you new content which is based on your previous one. Okay, and it is tailored just for you. So basically, ML algorithms improve over the time with more data, learning patterns, and make decisions based on past experiences. Next up, we have deep learning. But now, before we move into deep learning, if you are someone who is looking to make their career in data analytics and want to start learning with WsCube Tech, then our new cohort is going to launch soon. If you want to be a part of this cohort, the link for this program is given in our description. You can check it out now. Up next, we have deep learning. Guys, deep learning is a specialized area within machine learning that uses artificial neural networks with many layers. These networks can model complex patterns and data representations. Here, the examples could involve self-driving cars that use deep learning for image recognition to identify pedestrians, traffic, signs, and obstacles. Similarly, in our mobile phones, we have facial recognitions, right? Which again relies on deep learning techniques. So basically, while all deep learning is machine learning, not all machine learning uses deep learning. So DL is particularly powerful for handling large amounts of unstructured data, like images, audios, and even texts. And now lastly, we have generative AI. Generative AI is basically a type of AI that uses models, often based on deep learning, to create new content, whether it's text, images, music, or even video. For example, tools like ChatGPT, they generate human-like text, or platforms like DALL-E, it generates images from simple text descriptions, right? So that would be an example of generative AI. So basically, generative AI goes beyond analyzing data. It's about creativity and allowing machines to produce new or original work that can inspire and also entertain. So basically, in summary, AI is the big picture of making machines smart. ML lets those machines learn from data, and DL empowers them to understand complex patterns, and generative AI gives them the creative power to produce new content. So whether it's powering your favorite apps or even revolutionizing industries, these technologies are shaping our future in incredible ways. I hope the differences over here between all four of them is clear, and I hope you like this video. For more such content, stay tuned, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Do like, share, and subscribe.